Reports suggest a U.S. airstrike against a Syrian pro-government forces killed several hundred Russian mercenaries.
The doomsday clock moves even closer to midnight as a U.S. airstrike reportedly kills at least 200 Russian private military personnel in eastern Syria.
By Russian mercenaries on U.S. forces in Syria, that we are again in a Cold War. We are in conflict with Russia.
The Russian people today, Vladimir Putin claims he's developed a new arsenal of weapons that the U.S. cannot counter. These include a nuclear-powered cruise missile, a hypersonic missile that can strike anywhere, and a nuclear-powered underwater drone.
Expected Vladimir Putin's annual address to Parliament to involve advanced missile systems and strategic weapons amid talk of job creation. Putin reminding Russians that their country is a world power once again.
Putin's new weapons may, in fact, really be able to evade Western missile defense systems.
What's interesting is I don't think Americans are that focused on this.
President Vladimir Putin today unveiled a grand vision for his country's future and what he called the means to achieve it, new nuclear weapons.
No one wanted to speak with us constructively. No one has listened to us. You listen to us now. The nuclear weapons against Russia and its allies will be perceived as a nuclear attack on our country. The response will be immediate.
Putin's return to Cold War rhetoric comes 1 month after the U.S. announced its own plans to deploy new nuclear weapons and greater willingness to use nuclear weapons. Putin said he was responding to American threats.
The growing military strength of Russia is a secure guarantee of peace because this strength preserves and will always preserve a balance of power in the world.
To no surprise, Russian lawmakers responded with praise. They said Putin once again made Russia a global superpower.